This is Outnumbered. I'm Kayleigh McEnany, here with my co-host, Harris Faulkner. Also joining us, former State Department spokesperson and founder of Polaris National Security, Morgan Ortegas, senior fellow for the Independent Women's Forum and journalism fellow for the Steamboat Institute, Kayleigh McGee-White. And Fox News, IOC claims this was not their intent, but I do want to put up an image of the depiction of the lashes in point. He was even getting excited. And we all sat down as a family to watch this, and it wasn't just this.
Oh. The IOC spokesperson said, we check, and then you waited a while to swear, and those who support us, like our Jewish husbands or friends, know is they took a punch at us, and it's fair game for everybody.
Yeah.
It's my viewership. I didn't watch the whole thing anyway. I was so offended, I turned it off. But I am tuning in for those young men and doing they can to compete and represent their countries. I am, because it's a disease, and it's hateful.
Yeah, and it is about the athletes. You know, Kayleigh, when I was watching beautiful faces of these athletes who have worked their whole lives to sexualized images, even putting...
And at best, this could be called a disrespect on any competition. We look at what's still happening to Colorado. Examples of Christianity being the target.
And it should be. We should be...
And one of the common refrains that you'll hear on social media and from the leaders of China, Russia, North Korea, and Iran, what are they saying about us? They're attacking our culture. And they're trying to point out to their people, sort of making a mockery of the things that so many people hold dear. Our allies and partners in the global war on terrorism, they're with us in NATO, that were made.
Well, they had to pull somebody, I would imagine. They pulled some of their own citizens.
I'm sure they
found out it wasn't popular.
They must be offended, right? If you're a French citizen, you must be even more offended if you're a French Christian.
Well, I've talked to a lot of parents who have some very sad kids because they wanted to watch the opening ceremony, and you deprived them of that, France, so well done. Coming up, shocking new reporting reveals that
Morgan, but what we need now is the context. And, you know, President Trump's victim interview will be important to kind of give all of that transparency about the emotions of the moment and all of that. This shooter would have seen what was playing out on stage now. Such a great example of the falling down of leadership and no eyes on it from the White House. Fewer than 90 days out from October 7th, when Israel was attacked by Hamas terrorists, and more than, what, 200-300 days that the Ukraine war had been going on. We had serious things going on in the world. He didn't bother to let anybody know. I mean, what a mess. What an unmitigated, dangerous mess.
And reportedly communication.
But no accountability for not knowing where your SecDef is.
Yeah. Oh, and that's the singular problem with Washington, right, is that there's never any accountability for anything, whether it's this incident or in debt or any of the other problems with our federal government. There's no accountability. It's a very important thing. And then you have a guy like Christopher Wray, who's all, what does he do when he goes before Congress? He just starts spreading weird
about interviewing President Trump. So it's not like there would be any reason why they couldn't at this point sit down with him. I know he's running for
president. Has moved on so quickly is because they realized that that was a watershed moment for many American voters. But I watched that happen and suddenly was rethinking everything
around President Trump was not notified. Why not?
Well, look, C.B. Cotton did point to the fact, so that might have had something to do with it. I don't know if that was all radios, but that was in her report. There was a lot there.
A lot.
Okay. Coming up, Vice Presidential candidate J.D. Vance.
You could hear it from that crowd in St. Cloud, Minnesota. That was probably the best defense he has delivered forcefully, powerfully about his service.
Yeah, enlisting in the Marine Corps is hard.
Another time he did it, but Charlie, he did it first on Morning Joe, and NBC says he started the trend of using the word weird.
Yeah, and I don't even really get the point that he was trying to make there. It made no sense. But when it comes down to sort of I'll take that comparison any day.
Harris.
Yeah, I mean, J.D. Vance, easy layup for him. I mean, weirdly, you have the job I'm running for, he could say. Mm. And now there's new reporting at that debate. It is weird that she sat that close to Joe Biden and couldn't tell what we could see from afar when he was following.
They are the living proof that she was successful. My husband became the first struggles. And they see hope that someone in Washington is actually going to listen.
Well, we will have more news on this and much more tonight when former President Elizabeth Warren says 11 million illegal migrants need a pathway to citizenship and says Kamala is just the person to get it done.
Charlie Hurt.
This is one of those real issues that American voters really care about. 80% issue, and it affects the economy.
Of Bidenomics. When Bidenomics.
And Donald Trump is where the country is on immigration. Kamala Harris is not.
When you asked me that Bernie Sanders and Elizabeth Warren would be so supportive of the vice president because she's to the left.
I'm actually including this Elizabeth Warren.
New polling today, Pennsylvania, they are tied, Kamala Harris and Donald Trump. And I would point out, Minnesota, obviously, for the president, for Trump, would make a big difference. Look, I want to point.
Causing people not to have children. This was not a one-off, Kaylee. I went back and looked. July 31st and April 21st of 2023 alone. So it clears to be a Kamala talking point.
Yeah, and I'm Gen Z, and she's doing a math. It cites ridiculous rhetoric like what we just heard from Al Gore. It's completely unjustifiable.
You know, and Charlie, J.D. Vance said back, it's almost like these.
About there, and good night, what Al Gore is talking about there. That is the weirdest stuff you will ever hear. And what they can't talk about are the specifics, and they can't talk about the issues, because, again, 80, 90% of the agenda that Al Gore and Kamala Harris is pushing. People aren't, Americans aren't buying it.
Yeah, does she keep the new talking point in her new role? I mean, that'll be interesting to see.
Well, I do think that this is an opportunity to want to drive and how you want to propel your family forward, right? Well, I just want to point this out. So climate anxiety about being eaten down the food chain from lions, tigers, and bears. And this is an insult that we can't figure things out. It doesn't mean.
All right, more outnumbered next.